Happy New Year's, my subscribers. Just putting this one out before I go away for the day. I'm doing this on New Year's Eve 2019. What? It's like, yeah, almost 11 o'clock here on the East Coast here in beautiful mountainous Holbrook, Long Island. I am your reader, Mark Angelo Lyons Mal for short, professional witch, professional intuitive, and president of Drawing the Circle Productions, taking a day off after this to go into Brooklyn to get my hair did, and to hang out with my dear friend Mark. Yes, we are part of the Mark Collective. So we are going to hang out with some friends in Bushwick. I love Bushwick, Brooklyn. So much fun. Such a great place to hang out in. So I figured I was not going to record today, and then my guides were like, you know what, do this. I was like, oh, what a cute idea. So what we're going to do is we're going to pull a couple of cards, two cards for each sign. It's 24 cards tops, but we're going to do one Doreen Virtue Healing with the Angels Oracle and one Matt Kahn Healing Mantra Deck card for, not like New Year's resolutions or anything like that, set an intention for the year to be more loving, wise, and powerful than you've ever been before, because that you're going to do anyway if you're walking your path. This is about just for New Year's Eve, New Year's Day. A little angel, a little mantra with an emphasis on the latter. Now, you comment in the description box if you know that is sort of a distorted reference there. Cool. So let's take a few deep breaths. I'm going to pull the angel first, then I'm going to pull the mantra and quickly read you what is in the book in terms of the mantra. If you've been following along, my recent stuff just added this one. Really, really great, amazing deck. So let's have fun with this, right? Even though some of the mantra cards can be a little intense. So ground and center, grab your coffee. I call to my angels and my masters to please do these readings for me, that they be truly helpful, that they be a blessing upon any and all who watch, and that the guidance, the grace, the love, the power, and the wisdom be just that, graceful, easy, loving, powerful, and wise for the well-being of all. And so it is. Look, I'm not even wearing jewelry, folks. Nice deep breath. Once the cards hit the table, they're staying on the table. So I'm not. There's going to be no repeats, right? So yeah, oh, do you want to do sun, moon, rising? Oh, let's do sun, moon, rising. Let's not bring Venus into it. We're doing that for the twin flames. God, those twin flame reads. I love the spread, but they're so fucking intense. And I will get back to those tomorrow. I'm taking the day off. You want drunk tarot, you gotta get me to 1,000. Set my goals and I go for them, but I also set my boundaries and keep them. Shall we? Nice deep breath, here we go. Oh, my angels, there you are, please. One card for the Aries Sun Moon Rising sign for this New Year's Eve, New Year's Day. What's just a guiding, overlighting energy. Whoa, right out the gate, Aries, soulmate. All right, so you're looking for some kind of soulmate contract, right? If not a soulmate, because there is no twin flame card in this deck, could just be a soul contract. So look at your one-on-ones, right? Or it could be soul group, right? We'll keep that flexible, but I know everybody's ears just perked up, right? Everybody talks about the third eye. What about the third ear? Someone goes, like that invisible Scooby-Doo ear pop up over your head. Okay. So let's get a mantra here, please, for the Aries Collective Sun, Moon, Rising sign. Please, Matt and the Masters, considering they've got soulmate, what you got for them? Growing beyond guilt. Growing beyond guilt. It couldn't have happened any other way. Growing beyond guilt couldn't have happened any other way. Okay. Womp, womp, womp. Growing beyond guilt. These are really quick. Right? Oh, opened right to the page. Growing beyond guilt. It couldn't have happened any other way. When you grow beyond guilt, there is a heartfelt acceptance that any sequence of events unfolds in a perfect flow that is organized and expressed by the universe. The divine plan. This takes the pressure of control off your shoulders so you can enjoy the way in which life has come to be. Since everything is destined to change and can only change you for the better, growing beyond guilt enables you to see how exquisitely the gift of life unfolds. This mantra is ideal for releasing the past, good for New Year's Eve, New Year's Day, unhooking from karmic patterns, even better, and forgiving yourself, perfect, right? Perfect, perfect, perfect. So in any of your relationships, see them as soulmate contracts. A mantra has to be repeated. So just repeat it over and over and over, like putting in code over and over and over again. It couldn't have happened any other way. If someone says, well, what about, blah, 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 it couldn't have happened any other way. And you know, if you really want to freak them out, have a glass of champagne and go, it's the divine plan. And throw it in the fireplace. and then swoop away, right? Let's dive in. That was fun, right? I will keep these fun. I will keep it funny. I will keep it sunny. I will keep it gay. Look at my hair. I never do my hair like this. Because I'm having it done. Of course, I washed and conditioned it last night. You know, brushed it out, put it in a ponytail. I don't know. It's all sort of swoopy. It's not going to be short. Think Harry Hamlin, opening beach scene, Clash of the Titans. Yeah, that's what I shoot for. My angels, please, one card for the Taurus Collective, Sun, Moon, Rising sign for this New Year's Eve, New Year's Day. Please, an overlighting POV, angelic point of view. Ooh, divine timing. Nice, we like that, Taurus. I love the divine timing card, except when it's not going fast enough for me. You feel me? My fellow earth signs, my masters, please, what's going on with divine timing here? Because there are a couple of cards in here that talk about divine timing. Even that, the one the Aries got, growing beyond guilt, in a sense, can really help with that sense of time. So for this Taurus Collective Sun, Moon, Rising, please, Matt and the masters, one, what's a mantra for them for today and tomorrow? Polishing my heart, right? Like, polishing my heart. Feeling is a power that helps me heal. Feeling is a power that helps me heal. Let's look that puppy up. Polishing my heart. Feeling is a power that helps me heal. When your heart is polished, you are able to honor each emotion for its potent healing properties. Okay. Honor saying that each emotion, no matter what it has its own healing properties, right? A polished heart doesn't take sides, cast blame, or maintain grudges. It faces life openly, willing to feel whatever sensations life may inspire, just for the chance to transform into higher aspects of perfection. That's really hot. This mantra is ideal for unraveling emotional stuckness, which we all get there, unless you're a Pisces moon, easing worry and cultivating bravery. So, with divine timing. So if there's anything emotional, going on there, just to keep feeling it and know that it's just a matter of divine timing. Breathe, right? It's okay to feel what you're feeling. No one needs to know you're doing it, by the way. You know, you keep it behind the castle wall and still feel everything, right? Trust me. Earth sign. I getcha. Let's go to the Gemini, please, my angels. One overview, healing with the angels. Oh, really? Healing with the angels and the healing mantra. God, but really about healing. I get it. Now I get why you wanted both of them. I have a feeling we'll be doing this more. Breathe. For the Gemini Collective, Sun, Moon, Rising, my angels, please, one card for today and tomorrow, New Year's Eve, New Year's Day, healing. I should have known that was going to happen. All right, said it a couple of times. Healing, healing, healing. Well, we've got a trifecta there. My Geminis, you're almost triplets. Let's ask the masters what your mantra is, please, for this Gemini Collective, Sun, Moon, Rising, please, Matt and the masters, what is their mantra, Matt and the masters? Deconstructing doubt. Only my beliefs are in my way. Oh, that's so Gemini. Yeah, ask your other self, no, what do you mean? What are you talking about? Only my beliefs are in my way. That's fabulous. Deconstructing doubt. Only my beliefs are in my way. As you deconstruct doubt, you are no longer lost in the concerns and curiosities of what if, but are more rooted in the truth of what is. Ooh, that's helpful. Just the what if, what is. I like that. When doubt is deconstructed, hardship is no longer a sign of misfortune. It is an opportunity to step outside your comfort zone and meet the higher aspects of soul that exist just beyond the boundary of the self. This mantra is ideal for aligning with truth, being more self-actualized, and transforming inferiority. So with healing, that does make sense. So we're looking at belief healing, right? Mental healing. Only my beliefs are in my way. That is lovely. I'm digging this a lot. Please comment if you're digging this. I'll do this more often. Like, this is easy. Whoops, wrong deck. Deck confusion. That's what she said. Nice deep breath. Let's go to the Cancerian. My angel, please, the Cancerian sun, moon, rising signs, please. What's their overview? Guardian angel, having to do with the higher self, right? It's not just some winged celestial being following you around, right? It's the higher self, the fifth dimensional and above higher self. Sorry, making more room here. Okay, so think of that, that guardian angel, higher self, right? What's the mantra then, my masters, Matt and the masters for this Cancerian collective sun, moon, rising sign? We've got guardian angel. What's their mantra for New Year's Eve, New Year's Day? Anchoring the light, which is so very guardian angel, higher self, right? Because that is the lie. I am the light, the light I am. I am the light I am, right? Breathing that, being that, it's the truth of who we are. The light is always within me. Anchoring the light is always within me. That's really cool. That is so spot on, as the British like to say. Anchoring the light is always within me. When you anchor the light, you are accepting the infinite life force of the universe as your guardian. No shit. It's guardian. Guardians! As your guardian, navigator, and companion. As you anchor the light, you are no longer a person trying to find the deeper meaning of connection. Instead, you know yourself to be a living expression of connection, simply appearing human in form. Fuck, these are good. Thank you guys, what a great idea. This mantra is ideal for overcoming fear, reducing cravings, that's interesting, and making important life decisions. So my Cancerian collective, good luck with that. Remember, it's a mantra, you just gotta say it over and over and over again. The light is always within me. The light is always within me. I feel a lot of people pausing, running, grabbing a pen and paper, and then resuming. Good round. 4 in. This is kind of fast. This is kind of fun. It's only, what, 11:09? Oh, we're going to be at 11:11. We have to make a wish. I'll keep my eye on it.
Retroactive 11:11 wish.
My angels, please. Who we got next? Oh, lovely. Leo. Sun, moon, rising. I'm Leo rising. Can't you tell? Look at me. I'm in a bathrobe. But this is the magic bathrobe. One of several. I would live my life in bathrobes. Yeah. I'm a Dionysian archetype from jump. Nice deep breath. My angels, please, 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 please. One card, a lovely Healing with the Angels Oracle Dorian Virtue deck for the Leo Collective Sun, Moon, Rising. Please, what's their overview? Balance. Watch yourselves tonight, Leos. I know you like to be the center of the party. You like to be the sun upon which all else orbits. Make sure you keep in balance, because sometimes you can throw the whole bunch of things off balance when you're the center point, right? This is what I'm getting. Yeah, I'm driving into Brooklyn. I'm going to have my alcohol early. I'm not a big drinker, you know. I talk about it all the time. Watch the Drunk Tarot thing. Watch the Drunk Tarot. Oh, I'll put it. I'll try and remember to put that in the links. 1,000 subscribers, I'll do Drunk Tarot. It'll make you feel good. It's a very specific reference. If you know it, comment in the box below. If you can find it, find the link and put it in the box below. It would be hysterically funny. Matt and the Masters, please. For this Leo Collective Sun, Moon, Rising sign, we got balance from the angels. What is their mantra? No, that was two, please. Dancing with the Lion I just saw flash on TV. And it's 11, 11, 11, 11, make a wish. Done. And here's the mantra. Opening my mind. Do, 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 do. Oh, let's go back in time. Opening my mind, I allow myself to see beyond my beliefs and ideas. That's like the unexpected. With balance. Well, that makes sense with balance, right? I allow myself to see beyond my beliefs and ideas. Opening my mind. Polishing my heart, unbreak my heart, open my mind. I allow myself to see beyond my beliefs and ideas. When your mind opens, you are no longer limited by fearful beliefs or at odds with your own healing journey. With an open mind, you are aware of a bigger cosmic picture where your personal life ushers in your highest potential by uplifting the consciousness of humanity. Okay, as your mind opens, life is not just centered around your personal gains and losses, but shining your light for the well-being of all, wherever you happen to be. Oh, and therefore you, Leos, Leo rising here, we become sort of a point of balance, right? And so as we kind of see beyond what we're thinking of any situation, the conclusions we draw in any moment, that higher consciousness is literally present with us in the moment, balancing us out and balancing out everyone around us. This mantra is ideal for ending the inner negotiation with ego, absolutely, unraveling self-sabotage, good to know, and confronting the inevitability of loss, right? Because all that rises falls, erosion, renewal, the cycles of the moon. If you're pagan, you're a witch, you know what I mean, right? Samhain comes, and so does Dark Moon. So all about that balance of give and take and flow. Cool. Sounds like a lovely, stable way to have a New Year's Eve, New Year's Day. Ah, now but Virgo. Here we go. Let's not be crazy. Let's have a sip of coffee for Virgo. My angels, I'm Virgo Sun, if you're new to the channel. Do I say that every reading? Probably. My angels, please, one card in clarity for the Virgo Collective Sun, Moon, Rising Signs. A nice general overview for this New Year's Eve, New Year's Day. What do we got for the Virgos? Oop, manifestation. I'm down. Earth sign. Ding, 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 ding. Manifestation. Well, what? Tell me, Matt and the Masters. Breathe. I heard that. Breathe. Okay, Matt and the Masters, what is the healing mantra for the Virgo Collective Sun, Moon, Rising Signs for this New Year's Eve, New Year's Day? Embracing worthiness. I like this one. This is very visceral. This is a very earth-signy one. I feel worthiness filling every cell of my body, and it feels amazing! It is the Thorgy Thor card. Somebody commented on that. They said that before. And it really is. I've got Thorgy right here in my third eye. Hi, sweetheart. Don't know her, but know of her, obviously. Embracing worthiness. Here we go. Remember, with manifestation, I feel worthiness filling every cell of my body, and it feels amazing. When worthiness dawns, you know that life has a bigger plan in store. You are able to navigate the highs and lows of each moment, aware of a greater cosmic force at play. Worthiness grants you permission to honor all that you are and moves you in the direction that fulfills your deepest passions. So down for that tonight and tomorrow. This mantra is ideal for feeling more joy. Check. Working through creative blocks. Okay, check. And helping the body heal. Why not? I'm not drinking that much, but, you know, in general. Excellent. Wunderbar. Halfway through. This is fun. I'm digging this. Let's look at the Libras, because I'm Venus and Libra. We're only doing Sun, Moon, Rising, so. All right. We'll do it anyway. Nice deep breath for my Libs. Oh, my angels, please. One card in clarity, a healing with the angel oracle for this Libra collective. Sun, moon, rising, sign my angels, a card and overview. Support. And spiritual support, but certainly support of others in the 3D physical as well. Let's see what comes with the mantra for that. Please, my angels, for this Libra collective, sun, moon, rising, sign. What is their healing mantra for New Year's Eve, New Year's Day? Oh, awakening inspired action. There is only what life is asking of me. Inspired action. There is only what life is asking of me. Now, to me, I've gotten that one before. At this point, I don't know if I've worked with each one for a day, but I've certainly familiarized myself with this one. That one's very contemplative. So for a Libra, like, I can see the Libra, like, like, all day long doing the mantra and, like, questioning it at this. I don't know if I know what that means. So I'm going to read you what's in the thing, but I think it's sort of meant to do that. It's sort of meant to make you contemplate, well, then what is life asking of me? Sorry, where are you? Awakening inspired action. There is only what life is asking of me. When you awaken inspired action, you are an open, willing participant in your soul's journey. Okay, right? So you're like, okay, let's do this. You are ready, willing, and able to face any feeling or make any necessary change just for the chance to serve the cosmic plan of the universe, which is assuming you know what it is, and we don't, right? So it's that readiness. So there's a bit of faith in there too. It's inspired action, right? So you don't have to know the whole story. You know, ooh, this feels like the right thing to do. When inspired action has been awakened, you radiate higher frequencies of light for the well-being of all, right? So no matter, it's like, I don't know why I'm doing this, but I'm doing this, right? But it's for the highest good of all. This mantra is ideal for overcoming self-sabotage, resolving boredom, and increasing fulfillment, right? Because all of a sudden you turn and you get the inspired action to say, hi, I just have to say, your hair looks amazing. I do that to people. I'm just, because especially if they're doing overtone purple for brown, because you can tell when it's when you use it. I'm just like, oh my God, is that overtone? Yeah, oh my God, hi sister, you look beautiful. I love your hair color, right? In Stop and Shop is pretty much what I do. Food shopping. I don't know why it happens when I food shop, but it's Starbucks too. Very, very cool. Lovely. Put those two together. Just to, you know, to remind you, there is only what life is asking of me. There's only of what life is asking me. So if something pops up and you're like, oh, ding. It's like playing a video game. Kind of very fun. Scorpio. Let's see if the Scorpios have as much fun. My angels, please. One card in clarity for the Scorpio collective. Sun, moon, rising sign for this New Year's Eve and New Year's Day. What you got for them? Meditation. Makes sense for a Scorp to go within. Oh, it can be more, you know, contemplation into the soul. You know, they can be in a room full of 1,000 people and still be like, not wah, but something going on in there. No one else knows but them. Maybe another Scorpio would know. It's the stinger. Matt and the Masters, please. One card, please, for this Scorpio collective. Oh, flip that hair, bitch. Flip that hair. For this Scorpio collective, sun, moon, rising sign. Has meditation. What is a healing mantra for them? Oh, this one. Matt and the Ascended Masters, expressing free will. Meditation with expressing free will, to me right off the bat, that says, you all do what you gotta go do. I'm gonna go sit lotus for an hour. I'm gonna be mindful of being around y'all, right? My choices determine how brightly I shine. Right? So expressing free will. My choices determine how brightly I shine. Which actually, if you think about it, to be in a deep, centered space in a room full of 1,000 people, what a way to bless a room full of people, right? 1,000 people in a room, just to, right? The choices I make determine how brightly I shine. Hold on, hold on. Hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. Expressing free will, there we are. My choices determine how brightly I shine. When free will is expressed, the quality of your experiences, oh, that's plural, When free will is expressed, the quality of your experiences is based not on the actions of others, but on how wisely and lovingly each moment is viewed. It doesn't match the unconsciousness of others to fight or to have the final word. Instead, free will conveys the brightness of your soul through the sum of your words and actions, even when responding to those who aren't acting their best. This feels like you're going to be in a room full of 1,000 people and you're going to bump into some holy and assholy people, right? So you get to choose, right? Free will. Am I going to deal with this holy, or am I going to deal with this assholy, or is there going to be some kick assholy, right? This mantra is ideal for overcoming feelings of disempowerment, fulfilling personal goals, and becoming more ambitious. Worth looking into. Cool, cool. Sagittarians, really, just four more left. Sag, Cap, Aquarian, and Pisces. This is fun. I like doing this. I could see doing this once a week. Maybe with these exact decks. Maybe others. We'll see. Comment. You guys know my decks, my subscribers. Which would you like to see me do on a regular, like maybe on a monthly or a weekly? That we could just do Sun, Moon, Rising just like this all at once. Because if you do it with tarot, it just takes too long. It's easier with oracles. Because tarot, you can interpret 10 million ways. This is easy. Breathe. Oh, my angels, angels, angels. I don't have to be in Bushwick until 4. It's only 11:22. Plenty of time. And I'm driving. My angels, please, one card for the Sagittarian collective. Sun, Moon, Rising. I get the symbol in my third eye. Don't worry, it's not just what I say. Please, my angels, one card in clarity for this Sagittarian collective, Sun, Moon, Rising, for this New Year's Eve and New Year's Day. What is their overlighting energy? Celebration, rock and roll. That's what I want from my Saggies. I love my Sagges. I've never met a Sagittarian I did not get along with pretty damn instantly. I have no planets in it myself. Don't know why that is. But that celebration, great for New Year's Eve, New Year's Day. Kick up your heels. Put your legs in the air or your hands in the air, whatever, however that rolls for you. Just make sure it's consensual for you in particular. I know some Sagges that can really pack away the toxins. That's not a nice way to say it. It can drink you under the table. Nice deep breath. My masters, please. Yeah, they want to balance this out. Please, Matt and the masters. One healing mantra card for this Sagittarian collective, Sun, Moon, Rising, New Year's Eve, New Year's Day. What is their healing mantra, considering they've got celebration? Exploring unity consciousness. Ready? Ooh. Ooh, what does this button do? I am one eternal light appearing as all. Don't Sagittarians just live that way? I am one eternal light appearing as all. Although there's something Leo about that too. I am one, you are all extensions of me. I've boinked all 12 signs of the zodiac. Exploring unity consciousness. It's sort of like going abroad in Europe for a year. Boinking the belt, the zodiac. Exploring A, B, C, D, E. Do you ever do that even as an adult? Just gotta run through it. Did you know the alphabet song and Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star are the same tune? Discuss. Exploring unity consciousness. I am one eternal light appearing as all. Some of you are going, oh my God! When unity consciousness is explored, you are able to sense a connection that unites all hearts, no matter how unique each person seems to be. Ah, very cool, and a celebratory vibe there. In unity, there is a willingness to accept the differences that make each of us unique while embracing the greater cosmic web of interconnectivity throughout all time and space. And apparently run-on sentences. Sorry, I'm a Virgo bitch, aren't I? In exploring unity consciousness, you are not a person in search of the light. You are the light dressed up as a person along your soul's journey. Work, witch, work. This mantra is ideal for amplifying presence, as if we needed any help with that, grounding your energy, very good idea, Saggies, and deepening meditation. Fabulous. These are great. These are great. These are great. Three more. Oh, well, Capricorn, here we go. I love my caps. I do, I do, I do. But you're also damn serious. You're the Eeyores of the Zodiac. You ought to get, I'm a Virgo, but I was born the year of the monkey. I have proof, ready? Don't tell anybody I did that. Let's have a look at the Capricorns, please, my goats. My angels, please. One card in clarity. Some of you had to pick yourself up off the floor, didn't you? It's fun when I do these impromptu out of nowheres, huh? My angels, please, one card in clarity. For this Capricorn collective, sun, moon, rising sign, please, angels, for this New Year's Eve, New Year's Day, please, for my Cappies. Signs. I saw the signs, and it opened up my mind. I saw the signs. No one's going to drag you up to get into the light where you belong. God, there are some people I want to scream that at. So follow the signs, right? The synchronicities, I don't like the word coincidence. Let's call them quantum synchronicities, quantum events, right? Let's keep the word coincidence. There's no such thing as a coincidence. Coincidence is the ego's POV on that. Manifestation of unity consciousness. So, Matt and the Masters, I'm getting so buzzed off this process. Please. Oh, the oxygen's helping. Please, Matt and the Masters, one card for this Capricorn collective sun, moon, rising sign. Please, they got signs. It's such a great card, but a little neutral. Yeah, they're fun to watch. Keep an eye. The writing on the wall, the songs on the radio, the songs in your head. So please, a healing mantra for them, please, the Capricorn collective for this New Year's Eve, New Year's Day. Allowing appreciation. Allowing appreciation. Allowing appreciation. The value of my life increases each time I appreciate everything in it. Ooh, that is so Abraham Hicks waiting to happen. Allowing appreciation. Allowing appreciation. The value of my life increases each time I appreciate everything in it. When appreciation is allowed, everything is seen as a gift for the evolution of your soul. The more often you appreciate, the greater value you feel within your own life. While there is true worth in uncovering your life's purpose, most feelings of discontent are not caused by what you do or don't do. Very Capricornian to know. They are created simply by a lack of perceived value in your environment. Oh, I get it. It's like, this sucks. Why are we fucking doing this? I get it. Womp womp. Gee-poo. Poor Eeyore. I had a tack in his ass. Instead of waiting for things to get better before you allow appreciation, you must be willing to acknowledge the value in all things. This will awaken the feelings of elation that are always alive within you. Meaning that they're in there, but they're covered, right? This mantra is ideal for increasing worthiness, decreasing feelings of scarcity, and raising your vibration. That's just lovely. The value of my life increases each time I appreciate everything in it, right? Which means you can start in the detail and work up, or you can just go like a breath. I'm so appreciative for my breath. Start there, because your breath is your constant companion. Even when you croak, you exhale in this life, you inhale in the next world. It's how it is. It was a little heavy. Sorry. I'll try and keep it a little bit lighter, but hey, Capricorn, what are you going to do? Breathe. Oh, for my aquariums. Oh my god. Oh my god. What? It's so cosmic. Woo! Shake your honey bun. Shake your honey bun. Fred Schneider channel. Nice deep breath. For my Aquarians, please, angels, one card overview for the Aquarian Collective Sun, Moon, Rising. For this New Year's Eve, New Year's Day. What is their overview? Surrender and release Dorothy. surrender and release, which can be about just relax, you know? It's not always about hemorrhaging, giving something up. Grab the book, not the deck. Let's find out. Matt and the Masters, please, one card. What is the best healing mantra, considering really for the Aquarians, surrender and release, a lovely healing mantra for them? What would be most helpful for them for this this New Year's Eve, New Year's Day? Encountering conflict. Well, that would make sense with surrender and release. Like if you're in a push-pull tug-of-war, surrender and release. I don't choose sides. I take a stand. Now, I've been in some political discussions with some Aquarians in my lifetime, both sides of the aisle, by the way. It's in America, right? Fixed air. Y'all can be a little fixated. But you know, who isn't? That we identify with our points of view when we're polarized politically. But, you know, this is probably more than about that. I might be projecting onto y'all. Encountering conflict. I don't choose sides, I take a stand. When conflict is encountered, two opposing viewpoints wrestle for a dominant position. Each hopes to achieve success by changing the other's viewpoint. If encountering conflict from a conscious standpoint, you may realize one of the greatest gifts you can offer is allowing others to be heard. You may not agree with their argument, but you are embracing their needs simply by choosing to listen. When you listen instead of lash out, you are taking a stand for love. This is making the decision to anchor higher frequencies of light through the demonstration of your ethics, morals, and values, instead of matching the unconsciousness of others with equal amounts of aggression. This mantra is ideal for settling arguments, unraveling passive-aggressive behavior, I bet, and releasing the tendency to blame. So it really is saying, okay, I do not, you can totally, the child inside of you can be like, lift up my hair! Just be like, it's okay, honey. We're going to demonstrate love just by listening. And the thing is when you're fully present, focus on your breath and listening. You're so busy listening and being in the present moment and focusing on the breath that the critical voice may be running, but it seems to be running back here. So you really are allowing your soul to take a step forward. Surrender and release. Do you see it's surrender and releasing this old way of doing it? And you know, Aquarians, that is humanitarian. That is 11th house. That is being friendly, seeing things from a higher point of view. Very Aquarian. Oh, lovely. Last one down, Pisces. I'm a Pisces moon. Have I mentioned it a billion times? My angels, please, oh, let's end on a bang. Well, a good bang. Gang bang. Please, no, I'm 51. I ain't got time. I don't want to, no. I have nice sheets now. Please, my angels, one card in clarity for the Piscean Collective. I made somebody laugh really hard. Sun, moon, rise. It's like there's over 1,000 thread count. No way. Please, my angels, one card in clarity for the Piscean Collective sun, moon, rising sign, please. For this, I almost said new moon, for this New Year's Eve and New Year's Day, an overlighting healing angel self-acceptance, because we rock. Meow. We are the myrrh people. Myrrh. Self-acceptance for the Pisces, loving that, digging that, love what rises, my myrrh family, whatever that child needs to feel, you could go out of the bathroom for a little bit and say, go ahead, honey, I love you, okay, I feel better now, all right, let's go get a drink, or not, please, last card down, Matt and the Masters, please, what is the healing mantra for the Piscean Collective sun, moon, rising signs? For this New Year's Eve, New Year's Day. Lovely little mantra. Considering self-acceptance there, please. What's the mantra? Honoring adversity. Oh, here we go. I like this one, though. Honoring adversity. So this is probably going to be about the past, right? Honoring adversity. A fire reveals a path of renewed direction once the burning is complete. Isn't that like sort of Zen Koan-ish? A fire reveals a path of renewed direction once the burning is complete. That's like something, right? You go to a master and you say, but master, what should I do? A fire reveals a path of renewed direction once the burning is complete. Now, I don't know about y'all, but as a Pisces moon, I've been feeling everybody's everything for a while, obviously, in this lifetime. But this past year was intense. Like, a lot of dark night of the soul going on for a lot of people. I spent a lot of time in the underworld. So let's end this. Honoring adversity. You know, like, honoring, look back over your shoulder and go, you know what? Look at the resilience. Look what I lived through. You know, give yourself that love and that recognition, that self-acceptance, you know what I mean? All right, so honoring adversity. A fire reveals a path of renewed direction once the burning is complete. When adversity is honored, life is appreciated as oscillating cycles of deterioration and renewal. Solar, lunar cycles, you're with me. Deterioration is the natural process of new things becoming old, while renewal is the process of old things becoming new. Very much where we are, New Year's Eve, New Year's Day, just saying. As you learn to honor these two interconnected processes, just as naturally as the changing of seasons, you are able to embrace adversity. It is not a punishment, but a gift of renewal birthed out of the ashes of erosion. In other words, there ain't no phoenix until it goes to ashes, right? It's got to ashes rise, ashes rise, ashes rise, which is any moon cycle around here. Sometimes several times in 1 week. This mantra is ideal for processing unforeseen changes, right? A fire reveals a path of renewed direction once the burning is complete. I could see myself making that an ongoing daily mantra, Pisces moon. Overcoming superstitious beliefs, that's really cool. And surrendering the ego, which is really Pisces, that's our deal. Because it's really hard to be to feeling the collective of everybody's everything and the ego at the same time. So, my viewers, that was a little intense to end on, but that's the Masters and the Angels for you right there. I really hope you enjoyed this. If you are new, please do like and subscribe, if you will. Wishing you all a very happy, a very healthy, a very wealthy, and a very wise New Year's Eve and New Year's Day. Get your three mantras, work them, you know, unless you're like Leo Sun, Leo Moon, Leo Rising, but then you know everything anyway. I'm Leo Rising, I'm allowed to say that. Cool. And again, please comment in the description, in the description box, in the comments below, if you liked this, if you would like to see me do this more regularly. Certainly once I have super live chat, I can do this at the drop of a hat a little bit easier. But you know, if there are other decks you would like me to do this with, although I would keep tarot out of it. I can do it with the tarot card. Just have to keep the descriptions really quick if I'm going to do all 12 signs. Cool. Let's take a nice deep breath. Ready? You'll like this. I call upon my collective pantheons of angels, gods, goddesses, masters, and the higher selves of all involved to work through us, all who are watching or listening to this video, to bring to life the most fulfilling New Year's Eve and New Year's Day that we can have. Because we don't know how to make it the very best that it can be, so we ask the collective pantheons, the universe itself, the divine light, to work through us, making it the most fulfilling, to bring the most fulfilling version of New Year's Eve 2019 and New Year's Day 2020 to life in our lives, under grace and in perfect ways for the well-being of all. That I am now, and so it is. So motivated. Woo, rock on. Have fun. If you're going to drink, have a drink on me. Just go, Jamel! Marcangelo Lloydsmel for short. And wishing you the very best and the very blessed. And I'll see you next year. I love you all so much. Thank you for watching. Hail, farewell, New Year's Eve, and blessed be.